Oh my gosh. Hi. How's it going? How is everyone? Thank you for having me. Thank you very much.
Merlin, no one can hear you.
You might be muted, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, you're muted.
Ah.
No. Okay. We're given the talk to entertain you.
How about we hashtag right. plug
I'm
ourselves.
I'm here now. Okay.
Yeah? Can everyone hear him?
All right.
Oh, yep, he is.
All right, let's restart. Everybody be quiet, as if I hadn't said anything. Okay?
Okay.
All right, here we go. Yeah. Hello, everybody, and welcome back to VTuber Tabletop. Oh, my God. I'm your humble dungeon wizard, Merlin the Magister, saying this again, the second time.
No, I didn't hear anything.
What?
This is the first
thanks,
time
Pastel. See, Pastel's there. Let's get some quick announcements out of the way before we get to everybody's favorite part of the episode. We have our Generation 2 of VTuber Tabletop beginning soon, starring our new cast. I believe almost everybody is announced, so keep an eye out on that. That's going to be pretty cool. It takes place in the frozen north of Iruvian, on the subcontinent of Indus Val. Dealing with some spooky crystals and the Earth Genasi nation of Guyana. We also have Twitch commands for Generation 1, so let's everybody put in your favorite member. Mine is obviously Dante, and you'll get their stats.
That's just because you want to take over Dante.
That's true.
Oh shit, I ruined it, hold on.
We also have commands for people's Twitch channels. Wait, I think that's all of our announcements out of the way. Time for everybody to prep those emotes. Oh, Astrid was there first.
Yeah.
Time to hashtag.
As long as Wendy's not first, it's okay.
It's okay.
Doesn't count if the words haven't been said.
Time to hashtag plug ourselves. So let's start with Astrid Arcana.
Hey, it's me. Why do I keep starting it off with that? It's a me, Chris Pratt.
Yep.
Yahoo! I'm Astrid. I stream here on Twitch. I like to do a bunch of art. I also like to play a bunch of video games, like Skyrim and Fallout. And
Bethesda games, that's what you're saying, Bethesda games.
I'm the unofficial Bethesda streamer. Yeah. I'm psyched for today. I'm very, very, very psyched for today. Let's go.
Poggers. Mr. Usabeni Yume.
Did you just say poggers?
Poggers. Play of the game. Play of the game, everybody. Play
just
the game.
Sounded so unironic that the delivery was great.
Yes, well, hello everyone. My name is Usabeni Yume. I am the Rebel Poet, and you can find me on my YouTube channel. I also just recently started a Patreon, and I'll be working on that a little bit more. But I'm happy to be here today. Happy to have such a wonderful guest with us today. And please look forward to the very interesting game we'll have.
Okay, Mr. Windham Boss.
Yeah. I'm Windham. I'm Windham Vossler, a detective VTuber and part-time cat boy. I play a bunch of different games, pretty much every genre, but I do like a good RPG. I recently bought a Switch, so my channel has a lot of Switch content, and I will be playing the new Pokemon game later tonight, probably.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Snake. Pastel, though.
My name is Pastel. Pastel the Snake on Twitch and Twitter. I do Gundam building. I do video games. I do sometimes art, although we should be coming back next Wednesday, pending therapy. So hopefully that happens. Are we doing something on Monday?
I think we might be doing something on Monday. I finally have my computer back, so I'll be actually able to stream some building. I have some models to paint because I haven't painted in months. I need to get cracking on my orcs.
So yeah, maybe we'll do some model building on Mondays on this channel.
Amazing. And finally, our guest, Yuriza.
Hello, I'm Yuriza. I am incredibly nervous to be here. Hello. I do also stream on Twitch, and I usually do Arden Gaming. And I'm super excited for this game. Thank you so much for having me again. I'm sorry.
No.
I'm so excited.
We're very excited to have you here. And finally, I am Merlin the Magister. I'm going to remember to plug myself tonight. I am your humble dungeon wizard on Saturdays and Monday. Sundays. Sorry, it's Sunday for like most of the world. Monday morning for me. I do lots of stuff on my main channel. I've been kind of experimenting with stuff with different streams, variety streams. Been playing some chess, trying to get my chess skills up to par, and keep an eye out for some Apex Legends gameplay, which is going to be extremely mediocre, but it's coming. Cool. Well, I think that finishes us up for our introduction. Let's get to the episode recap and into the game. So, episode recap for episode 19, which I believe, what did I call? Oh, episode 19, Mommy Issues. Recovering from her mother's charm spell, Emeth storms back into her childhood home to confront her mother. Past the point of words, Emeth takes the first shots, loading her feelings into her gun. However, her surprise attack falters in the presence of her mother, who stands there unfazed. Emeth tries one last time to let her mother know that she's found people that she cares about, but her words are only met with her mother's attack. Delnoa turns invisible and stabs Emeth using her claws, revealing her true form, a succubus. With fear and shock, Emeth flees from the succubi's den, using her dagger to turn invisible. She flees to the company of Matif and Lucy and tells the story of what had just transpired. With mixed feelings, Emeth discusses everything and, with the support of the rest of the party, comes to the conclusion that her mother needs to be killed. Emeth, Lucy, and Matif share a heartfelt moment and reassure each other that friends are only a quick glance away. Fulfilling their appointment with Hanzo, "Hey, what you doing, hey?" The trio go to Rip It in order to outfit themselves with replacement arm prosthetics. Although the feeling is new and strange, the two get used to their arms fairly quickly, and Lucy lays down a line with Hanzo for a potential future business partnership. However, outside the shop, Lucy notices that they are being watched by what seems to be a spell thief, and the three attempt to corner him in an alley unsuccessfully. Following that, and with the urgent matter of keeping the sacred instrument safe, the three venture to the forest to find their companion Dante. Although their attempt to find him is unsuccessful, Dante appears to them in the form of a majestic elk and displays the extent of his newly acquired powers. However, their reunion is cut short when the sky turns to a familiar, ominous red. Arriving at the source, the group encounters a pack of four powerful demons, with one of them being Delnoa herself. The group attacks, with Emeth leading the confrontation. The battle is difficult, yet the party is able to hold their own against the demons. Witnessing their combined strength, Delnoa attempts to turn the tides by controlling Emeth and having her attack Lucy. However, the spirit crew of Matif rush to his companion's aid and fight off the demon with ease. However, one is able to get away using the plane shift spell after a valiant yet failed attempt by Dante to counterspell. With their defeat, the sky turns back to its normal calm blue, and Delnoa tells Emeth that she can find further answers in her house. The group searches the place, and Emeth stumbles upon a box which reveals answers and raises even more questions. Princess Evelina, daughter of Prince Anders III and Baroness Ingrid of Pintica. A wanted poster for a missing elvish child in the port town of Harstad, and Pillager's Cove Pirate Commission notes outlining Captain Delnoa of the Nala. Four pieces of information on which the group tries to make sense of before being asked by Gustin to undertake their next quest. Find the third instrument. The most powerful of the three, a violin. The group decides to undertake their quest, but Lucy needs to find answers about Eve before traveling to the other side of the world. So, you dudes, I believe, are still at... No, you guys are walking towards Xandros's building, correct?
At least Lucy is. I don't know about everyone else.
Hey, I don't know what the fuck you guys are doing.
I'm gonna follow Lucy, I suppose.
Okay.
Yeah, me too.
I'll go with the group.
Okay. You all begin walking towards, I believe where Gustin pointed out, the new headquarters of the West Arwa Company, the company which Xandros owns. It's quite a walk away, so you guys have some time to talk and sort things out, if you would like.
I forget, did I let everyone know? Yeah, everyone knows why we're going there.
Yeah, I believe you did. You did. Correctly. You did tell everybody why you wanted to go. Okay.
So, you know y'all don't have to come with me, right?
We know, but I don't have anything else to do. Right now, at least.
Yeah. And, Matif, I don't know if this might bring up any past ghosts of yours, but...
You mean like ones that just fought with us?
Not those ones, but I meant the ones that still happen to be alive. If you get what I'm saying.
Don't think there's any...
Ooh. Well, also... It's not just because I have nothing better to do. This is important to you, right? You know? You've been sticking with me for all my hardships. I, you know, figure I should be there for you now.
You know, and that means a lot to me. And, if she comes to me, I'm sure she'd love to meet you. But it's been so long, I'm not really sure where or what she is at the moment. But that's what I need to figure out before we leave, basically.
Yeah. Well, suppose we should head off then, right?
And, yeah, I'll just let you see her when you meet her. She's a very interesting character. She's actually the first one who taught me how to appreciate poetry.
Oh.
Yeah. Nice. So if anything, she has as good as of a way of words as I do.
I find that hard to believe.
Matif rolls his eyes, not excited.
More mouthy fucking poets. Oh my god. Matif's like, worst nightmare. Oh,
there's more of them.
Yeah, and let me tell you, Matif, she's just as fiery as me. So you two will get along just fine.
I
yeah?
Sure.
Sorry.
And yeah, she'll love you too, Dante, for sure.
I guess that's nice, yeah?
Out of character, you're saying this like we're getting a new mom.
Are you insinuating Lucy is the dad?
Yeah.
Daddy? Okay. What? Sorry, my mic glitched out a little bit.
Sure, sure.
I don't know what happened. Oh, I don't know what happened there.
Anyways, all of you make your way towards the relative center of the city, towards the beautiful marbled building, which is the Diplomatic Forum, and just a stone's throw away up the street, you see a very similar looking building to what you guys saw originally in the Pago Fort. Seems to be some sort of sandstone or some similar kind of sandy material, with a large dome at the top which has been painted blue. There are long curtains and beads that hang at the door, which you can easily push through. There is no like door like with some of the other buildings, and you guys are free to approach the inside of the new West Arwa Company building.
Before we all go in there, I don't know about y'all, but Xandros is a little suspicious to me, so I think it would be nice to set up some safeguards in case we need to fight or run, whatever it may be.
Could we please not get into trouble this fast again?
Yeah, well, I wasn't necessarily planning on it, but who knows what that son of a bitch has up his sleeve. And be better for us to be safe. You know, like a code word in case something goes wrong, or a way to signal to each other in case we feel like we're getting into too much trouble. What do y'all think?
Seems fair. But...
A word to keep us safe, as it will.
Oh.
A safe word?
Oh, you're hilarious. Yes, yeah, what's a safe word? What's... I don't know, Dante, you pick one.
Any
word. I said a word, not a phrase, come on.
Honestly, if it's just like, and anybody but Dante does it, that could be our safe word.
I just feel like it's a big thing. Like what if someone says it on accident?
Oh, well, that's why you got to make it a really specific word that's has nothing to do with the situation we're in.
Make it a word with a synonym.
Oh.
That way we can use the synonym instead of the word.
Can I chime in?
Oh, sure.
What about if we say Amish? If he comes
up in the conversation. Who the fuck is gonna bring Amish?
No, that's what I'm saying. If he comes up in the conversation, like, if we ask how Amish is doing, then that's how we know that shit might go down.
That's smart, seeing it as he's, you know, not here with us. It wouldn't make sense for us to bring him up, and he doesn't really relate directly to the situation, so...
How about a non-verbal? I have an idea. If, I've got two ideas, right?
Go on.
We can, if we just want to signal to one of us before shit hits the fan, or all of us, I don't really care. We could do 3 taps.
Without feet?
Well, you could do it with your feet, but I meant like, oh shit, you don't have arms.
They do now. They have their arms.
I just got like hand to hand. Oh yeah, you do. Oh fuck yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Do you have feeling in your metal arms?
I don't think we do. No.
They don't have feeling in their metal.
No, we do.
Okay, well then, it doesn't matter.
No.
Never mind. 3 taps on their feet would work.
Yeah, that works.
Shall we do both, just to be safe?
Well, whichever one's easy, maybe.
Alright.
If we're in a position where we can speak freely, we could, you know, throw them into the conversation, and if it's not easy to speak, or we need to be silent, or, you know, if we're hiding, or whatever the situation may throw at us, the taps seem like a good idea.
Yeah.
So
sounds great to me.
You can never be too careful when you deal with someone like this.
They're both a backup for each other. You know, whichever one suits, I suppose.
Well, shall we enter?
I suppose we shall.
Okay. You will make your way up the steps of the West Arbor Company building.
Make them away.
You walk up the steps and into the huge circular chamber. You can see that there are individuals behind barred kind of booths. Like imagine a bank, but like a medieval bank. You see that there are many kind of tellers. People seem to be taking out loans and whatnot. Many of the people in here seem to be on the wealthier side. You can see a lot of people in very elaborate robes and other sort of related clothing. You do see that there is a front desk right at the beginning of this chamber where there is a small line. But after waiting for maybe 10 minutes, you eventually get to the woman at the front who appears to be a older orcish woman, probably in her like early 60s. She looks up at you as you approach.
Hello. Can we get a meeting with Xandros if possible?
Yeah, you want a meeting with Xandros? All right, I'll put you down. What name can I give him?
I look back to the group, kind of with a face. Should we give him our real name or?
Didn't we have a group name?
We did.
We agree on that. I can't remember.
For now, just put it down as L. Just the letter L. He'll know who it is.
Just the letter L. All right.
She takes down the letter L on a piece of paper, looks a bit confused, passes it to kind of like an assistant that seems to be standing off to the side. The assistant runs off and runs down a spiral staircase that goes down into the ground. They run off for a while before returning and whisper something into the woman's ear.
Yeah, he'll see you now. Just follow this young lad, and he'll take you to where you need to go.
Now, before we go down, can I do a perception check to see if there's any, like, heavily armed guards or...
Sure, go for it.
I don't know if cameras exist in this place, but anything to, like, spy on
fantasy
people.
Fantasy cameras.
Right.
17.
I rolled a 17, yes.
You take a quick look around. You see that there are probably about 6 armed guards in this building. 4 of them appear to be like private mercenaries, with, you know, nondescript, either plate mail or scale mail. All of them seem to be wearing the very classic blue and yellow colors of the West Awa Company. Seems to be hired mercenaries. However, there are two Diplomatica guards with purple cloaks. One of them is human and the other one appears to be gnomish. Who, with the 17, you can see are keeping an eye on you specifically, Lucy.
Great. And then we'll just follow them down.
Okay. You follow the young lad down. He's probably a orcish boy, probably about 16. Takes you down into the main section, which is Xandros's office. It's very similar to the one you guys saw in the Pego Fort, although it appears to be a little bit smaller. Room's probably about 30 feet long by 15 or so feet wide. You can see at the far end of the chamber, Xandros is sitting behind a very nice mahogany desk. You know it's nice because it's mahogany. sits behind
Fancy.
The desk. And all of you make perception checks as you walk in.
Oh no.
Except for you, Eureza, obviously.
Yeah.
I am Eight. Very perceptive.
Matif.
13.
There are three hooks on the wall behind Xandros that are very reminiscent of the ones that once held the instruments back in...
Yeah.
Which are empty.
I remember this conversation. It was one of the first conversations me and Emma had that mm-hmm. I was like, oh shit, this could kill me.
But other than that, he appears to be alone.
He used to be alone. Nice. he's sitting at his desk.
Yep, he's sitting behind his desk. He's kind of got his feet up. His feet are on the desk. They're kind of like, he's kind of at an angle. His hands are behind his head. His turban is off at the moment. He's kind of put it to the side. And you can see that he is completely bald and seems to be scarred on the top of his head.
Is there a chair that we can sit on?
There are several chairs in front of his desk. Four, to be exact.
So Lucy's gonna saunter over to the chair and kick his feet up on the desk as well.
Can I make like some kind of insight check to see if he knew that we were coming?
Sure, make an insight check.
It's an 8. No.
He looks like he. Wow, he sure is surprised. Aw, shucks.
Okay.
So all of you walk in and... Sorry, give me 3 seconds. I'm definitely not rolling dice. Don't even worry about it, guys. Don't even worry about it.
I wanted to say that if this goes shit south, that I do have mage armor on from earlier.
Okay.
And I am wearing my glass.
Okay. I do believe your bark skin is also up, Dante.
Yes.
Or,
it is.
Does that last 8 hours or 1 hour?
1 hour.
1 hour. Okay. It would have faded by this point.
Okay, then.
But you do still have. You've got plenty of other stuff. I'm not worried about you.
Also, is that a short rest or are we not rested at all?
You guys didn't take a rest. Kidding me? Okay.
Just wondering. We just went.
You killed some demons, went to Emmeth's mom's house, looked at the stuff there, went, oh, gee, okay, Gustin, let's go visit Xandros. And wandered over to Xandros' place. This is like an hour and a half after you just killed Emmeth's mom. Well, kill is a loose word. She's a demon, so she's not technically dead. But
she ain't
slay.
Here right now.
She ain't corporal.
Slay!
So.
Is there any like magic that I would detect that feels like not ordinary?
Sure. What was with a perception of 13? There appears to be a knife that is strapped to Xandros's boot, like underneath his boot, he seems to have an enchanted dagger. The clothes that Xandros is wearing also appears to be some sort of magic. And you can sense that there are other magical objects in this room, but you cannot see them. But you can sense, okay. You can see like vague outlines that there's something in the room, but you're not like, you can't see them. You know what I mean?
Right. I think the spell says there's auras.
Yeah, you can see several auras in the room, but you're not sure what they are. So yeah, see that. So you walk in, take a seat.
Oh yeah, hello. Welcome back, adventurers. I haven't seen you guys in a while.
I forgot that he had this voice.
Oh yeah, hello. My name is Korg. I'm made of rocks.
Anyways.
Anyways, hello. What brings you to my humble abode today?
So Xandros, I'm gonna just cut to the chase. Because you and I are both smart enough to know that some shit went down. Like a month or 2 months ago. And so where's Eve?
I believe canonically it's been less than a week.
Less than a week.
I believe.
What?
No. It's been longer than that, yeah. It's been a week to 2 weeks. It hasn't been a month. It's been like at max 2 weeks. He looks at you dead in the eyes and he says,
yeah, I don't know who you're talking about, man. Never heard that name in my life.
So is he leaning into me?
Is he what?
You said he's leaning into me.
Oh, he like leans forward.
Okay. Also, I'm sitting on his chair with my feet on his desk, and mm-hmm. I'll lean forward as well. And I'll say, so if you remember on that little boat of yours, there was a girl there with silver hair, silver eyes, ring a bell.
He looks he looks up for a second, yeah, as if he's like remembering something.
Yeah, don't think I remember anybody by that description. Yeah, I'm sorry, man.
Is he a lion?
Make insight check. If you want?
Make an insight check. Can I make one as well?
Yeah, go for
it. If you want.
This is a big sussy bucka energy.
Four, so no, I have no idea. No.
He rolled really low. You don't... There is some element of mistruth to what he's saying, Lucy.
So, Xandros.
Yeah, man?
What will it take for you to... remember who I'm looking for?
Yeah, I believe my normal price is about 2 million gold and two beautiful women.
You know, you know it's damn well that you already have 2 million gold.
Yeah, I think I've got more than that.
Yeah. So, what do you have to hide from? What do you have to gain from hiding Eve from you?
Yeah, well, I don't think you're in any particular position to threaten me. Yeah, we found those posters that you posted. Yeah, that's not a great sentence. The posters that you put up in the academy. Want to rally some mistrust against the government. Heavy fines for that. Not a great
move. What? Why? I thought we learned this lesson.
Are you talking to Lucy or?
I'm talking to Lucy. Oh, sorry, Matip. Yeah.
Okay. Lucy is going to ignore that for now.
And Matip will give up with an exasperated like shoulder. What is it called?
And so, I'll look at him and be like, and look towards the empty hooks that he has. Hey, what's supposed to go on those hooks right there, Xandros?
He gives a cheeky little smirk.
feel like something's missing there. But you know what? I feel like a good instrument would look really well there. No, maybe like a cello.
Oh my fucking god. Matif cannot hold his shit. He's like looking like, what the fuck are you doing?
I'm like, okay, I'm assuming I'm next to him. I'm just gonna like tightly kind of grab the back of his shirt, kind of like tugging on it, like, what the fuck are you doing? Why are you mentioning that?
Okay, Matif, Dante, and Emma.
Roll deception check.
Yeah, make a quick perception check, real quick.
Perception or deception?
Wait, what were you trying to deceive? Sorry, real quick.
What? Just that the face that I'm making.
Yeah. Sure, you can try and make a deception check if you'd like. I thought you said perception.
I'm just pulling on the back of his shirt. I'm not really trying to.
Oh fuck me, that's an 8.
Matif's pissed. Okay, yeah. Matif, Dante, and Emeth. Matif.
Hmm?
You see briefly some sort of dust, magical dust, emerge in front of you for a brief second through the through your glasses before Emeth, Dante, and Matif fall unconscious from the sleep spell.
No!
Do we not get a constitution saving throw?
There is no...
Oi! Magic can't put me to sleep.
Magic cannot put you to sleep. God damn it.
Ooh. Get fucked, Merlin.
Okay.
This'll be the first time I sleep in months.
Dante, you...
Magic can't put me to sleep.
Dante, you fall unconscious. Matif, Emeth, Lucy. You see Dante... platter to the floor. You see a magical dust, Matif, because of your glasses. And you hear the loud, heavy footfalls of armored individuals coming down the stairs behind you.
I'm gonna go with this is an Amish situation right here.
Yep. Well.
Wait, I said Amish. I mean a mesh.
Where's Amish when you need him?
Yep. So, I'm afraid I'm gonna have to put you all under arrest for inciting violence and intention to form an unauthorized militia in our great city. So if you could just follow the guards to your cells, we will keep this all very civil.
Okay, is there a window?
You're underground.
We're underground.
You walk down a spiral staircase into his underground office. Yes, Matif.
Here's a question. What the fuck did we do wrong? I understand that this motherfucker did something wrong.
You are accomplices.
Hold on.
This shit was going down. If I did, I would have told him to stop.
Well, that's the thing.
Question: What level spell slot is invisibility on my dagger?
It is cast at second, which is the base spell slot for invisibility. You've also already used it today.
Oh, I did too. Yeah. Okay.
So, while they're doing that, I'd say Lucy's still kind of calm. And he leans into Zandros even closer.
I noticed I cannot be forced to sleep either.
Oh, really?
Yes. Oh my god, are you
sleeping? Sleeping.
So I had a goddamn spell thief waste a third level spell slot trying to put you motherfuckers to sleep, but it didn't even work.
Oh no! What a shame.
Fine. So.
I guess I don't pick up my
Dante, you briefly Dante. Pass out before you reawaken and go, that magic shouldn't work on me, and just stand back up.
You're just I'm very so tired.
So.
Alright. So, back to business, Sandros. I'm sure you're dying to know where that violin is. Am I right or am I right?
Xandros kind of like laughs for a second.
Yeah, man, I'm afraid I've got bigger fish to fry than a little violin. Look, the world's fallen to shit, and I'm making a bunch of money, so I can go looking for that later. Sound like a deal?
And he smiles at you, and then you see his form fade. Because it was an illusion. The whole time.
Oh, god.
No fucking way.
Over there, here.
And then are those guards that came downstairs?
Yes. You see walking down the... walking down the spiral staircase is a group of 12 fully armored guards.
Only 12, huh?
All of them...
There's 12!
All of them are... like, Liu Pai official, like, military. They're not... These aren't, like, hired mercenaries. These are official, like, military people.
Okay.
You see a mixture of gnomes, dragonborn, human. You see a whole array.
Is there a door?
Yeah, the spiral staircase, which they are blocking.
And so
no, I mean, like, a door just on to the room specifically, like, in between us.
What do you mean?
In between the guards and us in the room.
It is one long room. There is one spiral staircase that leads upwards, as far as you're aware.
So as they approach, Lucy's going to, I guess, get in front of everyone.
How wide is the room?
How wide?
Yes.
Yeah.
I believe 15 feet. 15 feet wide, 30 feet long.
If I wanted to try and use Mold Earth to make the ceiling move, perhaps.
Well, and collapse it.
Yeah.
Oh. No, we'll be stuck down here too!
No, I don't think we will be. Just cause...
I can move it afterwards.
Well, I also have an idea, but it only gets me out of the situation.
Yeah, but there has to be
some... That's a bad idea.
Well, this is what
I'm just saying. Wait, it would be a fun callback.
Wouldn't there be... another exit out of here? It'd be pretty fucking dumb if that was the only entrance to an underground office. Being someone as high as up as Xandros.
You are under arrest in the name of Mr. Xandros, elected official to the Council of Nine. Please put your hands behind your back. No magical weapons, please.
Is there, is he, like, the leader that's speaking to us of this little...
Yeah, it's one guard seems to be more heavily armored than the rest.
Yeah, sorry, can I get your name?
You may not, you're under arrest. Please put your hands behind your back. Please do not cast any magic.
No. What if he just didn't arrest us? What do you think?
Make a persuasion check.
This is what I've been waiting for, ladies and gentlemen, and everything in between.
But what if you just didn't do the thing?
28.
Holy you shit. Squish your titties together. And the,
yes!
The guard looks at you, looks you up and down. Yeah, you can go, but the rest of you, the other three, you're under arrest.
Sorry, let me... I'll rephrase it. See, what if you just didn't arrest us, honey?
Yeah, I think
that's a little more.
That's
how I would have said it.
I've just told you. You can go. I don't think... We don't have orders to arrest you.
Right? But do you have orders to arrest them? Who did you have orders to arrest? Who... What were you actually
Fair
told?
Play.
Yeah, who were you actually told
Cowboy,
to arrest?
Come with us.
You can't arrest someone if you don't have confirmation of who you're actually arresting.
Yeah,
it's
too much talking, he looks behind. Jimmy!
I'll just, put my finger to my mouth and I'll just go with him.
Okay.
Like, kind of telling them to be quiet and then I'll just go with them.
Okay.
While all that was going on, Dante had already put his hands on his back.
Okay. Little lawful good, Dante. Real quick, I need to redo a thing real quick. This is not.
So, Wait, so they're not actually arresting us now?
No.
Nope, just Lucy.
Just Lucy.
Back to the old just grind.
The power of titties.
And I'm just gonna shake my head and under my breath.
Power of titties.
Oh, we won.
Yep, please, you three, please return to your inn. There will be a representative to see you shortly for further questioning. What inn were you staying at? He's talking to you three.
We're at the Dragonfire Inn.
Yep, a representative will be there to question you shortly.
No worries.
The three of you exit the establishment. Lucy, you are taken into custody with the guards, who promptly knock you out. With a mixture of the sleep smell spell and just hitting you.
I'm not going to go back to the Dragonfire Inn, obviously. I'm going to go back to my house.
Okay. We will come back to you three shortly.
Oh.
So, Lucy. Sometime later, and I will move you to the page.
Page?
The page?
Oh no, I have my own page.
Ooh. Whoa, oh, what shoot. The fuck? Oh my god. Oh my god.
Is roll 20?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
20.
Have you guys panned to the other side of the room?
I will go to the battles.
Oh. Oh no.
Oh my god.
My boy.
Oh my god. Oh
somebody
wait,
come
I
get her.
We can't look at the actual stream because it shows the blacked out areas.
Yeah, please don't look at the stream. Just
Hi.
So.
There's a lot going on.
Lucy, sometime later, you come to consciousness. You are in a iron cage. It seems some sort of, you know, jail cell. You can see that there is a guard posted just outside your door. There seems to be somebody in the adjoining cell who seems to be unconscious. And you can also see that there's another guard across the way, but you can't see who specifically is in the cell across.
Do I have my arms?
You have all of your gear except for your weapons.
Okay. Is it dark inside?
There's some sort of dim lighting. There is a kind of skylight above you, but it's at an angle. So it's on the wall, but it's very high up, as if you're underground. So you do get some natural light. Apart from that, there is a couple of torches placed throughout the room, but there isn't any particular... What's the word? There isn't any other lighting source that you can see.
Okay. Do have dark vision, but I won't look around just yet because of the belt. But I'll go up to the bars and take a look at this guard. Mm-hmm. Is he heavily armed?
He is extremely armed. He is wearing plate armor. And is wielding a greatsword.
Okay. So I'm gonna call out to him. Hey, buddy. Would you mind telling me where I am?
Yeah, that'd be against my orders, so I don't think so, no. Fuck off.
No, you got orders now. Who gave you those orders? Would it be Xandros?
He doesn't respond.
By the way, seems like an awful lot to keep someone like a little old me over here.
Not for you. Several other dangerous individuals.
Ooh,
don't know what a one-armed
so I'm
cripple
dangerous
would
now.
Threaten me with, but
are you calling me a cripple?
Ooh.
Yeah, don't see any other cripples here.
So you're saying you can beat me in a fight, is that it?
He just smiles and walks away.
Can I see where he walks to?
You see he walks to about here, where he still has eyesight on you, but he's far enough away where you would have to yell to talk to him.
So I'm going to yell at him again, from wherever he is. So, how long do you think it'll take before I get out of here?
You see him take a stone from his pocket and speak a word into it, and you feel a bracelet, something you didn't realize had been put on you, begins to slightly vibrate before you are electrocuted. For 3 Ooh. Lightning damage.
Alright.
Man, couldn't be me. I'm immune to lightning damage just for context.
I'm just too cool for that shit.
Yeah.
Well, then Lisa will be like, damn. And then I guess he'll look around the cell that he's in.
Okay, make a perception check. Realize I'm gonna move myself over a little bit so people can see the rolls.
21 on that perception check.
You can see that the cell is made of rough hewn stone. There is a small wooden bed with a straw mattress inside. There's a bucket. And a skylight.
And you also said that I can see someone unconscious in the cell next to me?
Yes, you can.
Then I'll go ahead and... Is it bars separating us?
Yeah, it's just bars.
Alright. Well, I'll walk over there and say, hey, apparently we're all dangerous people in here. What are you in for?
As you walk over...
Unconscious.
You do notice that she's unconscious, but as you come within probably about 5 feet of her, as you lean up against the bars, some sort of electricity forms between you, like a solid line of electricity that sparks for a second. Different to the kind of blue lightning or white lightning that Matif makes. This is slightly pinkish. And this thin line of pink electricity forms and then sparks, disappears. And Yuriza, would you like to describe your character as she awakens?
Oh my god. She, lying down on her back, basically jolts up with a gasp, immediately looks around. Spots Lucy in the other cell and first of all gets her bearings of where the hell she is, mm-hmm. because she has no idea what this place is.
Yeah. You wake up in a cell, rough,
yes.
stone.
What do I see?
Same description as I gave Lucy. It's nothing mm-hmm. is particularly different about your cell. You are still wearing your armor, though.
Ah, okay. But I don't
have
my sword.
Same with you, Lucy, as well. No, you don't have your sword or shield, but you are still wearing your armor. Same with you, Lucy. You are still wearing your armor.
Okay.
What the fuck is going on in here? Who are you? Wait a minute.
First time.
Who am I?
Wait.
Nothing.
Say...
Please. No, continue. What?
Yeah. Seems like it's a first time for you. In jail, I mean.
This is jail? Why am I in... I guess so. Who are you exactly? And where are we? What time is it?
Let's say Lucy gives a puzzled look, and I want to do an insight check to see if she's playing dumb.
Sure. 14. Yuriza, with a 14, is Rowan playing dumb? Give whatever description you think fits a 14, whatever information you would give away for a 14.
It would appear that she's just an absolute idiot, honestly. But she does seem disturbed, at least.
Okay. By the way, did you happen to catch that little spark between us?
Are you coming on to me? Like, what the fuck?
No.
What's
funny? Never mind. But you... Sorry. Let me take a step back a little bit. The name's...
Lucy. Sorry. I couldn't help myself.
Did you want to jump in, Merlin?
No. I knew it was coming, the way you say Lucy.
One of the cards. It's just like, his name's Lucy.
Yeah.
Short for Lucifer. What's your name, if I may ask?
Lucifer, now that's a good name. My name is Rowan.
Why did you say that like it's not true?
Mateef says from in the alleyway above.
Well, nice to meet you, Rowan.
Nice to meet you, Lucy. I hold up a hand like I want to shake his hand.
I look over to the guard. Is he looking at us?
Not particularly. He doesn't seem to be paying too much attention to you.
Okay. And when I shake her hand, can I shake it in a way to gauge how strong she is?
Make an insight check. Oh no, it wouldn't be insight. It wouldn't be insight. Give me a sec. Let me figure out what that would be.
Ignore that four then.
Yeah, we'll ignore the four. Make an athletics check. You're checking out the athletic ability. This is a strange way to do athletics, but I think it's natural one.
Well, that's it.
This is quite possibly the weakest person you've ever met. Probably weaker than Dante. Easy.
So nice to meet you. Do you really not know why you're here?
No, I don't. We seem to be in quite the predicament, aren't we?
Yeah, I would say so. But it wouldn't be my first time in jail, unfortunately.
You're a criminal.
Yeah, maybe you could call me a criminal. I guess it depends on who you ask.
Well, all right. We can work on that later. What do you have? I need more information on this. I kind of have no idea what the hell. Are we under? Yes, we seem to be under the earth. All right. What are you in for? Is this a prison for people who steal fruit or for people who overthrow the government?
That second one was oddly specific.
Well, there's so many. I don't even. Don't get me started.
Yeah. What if I told you I'd do both? Steal fruit and overthrow the government. Would that make me the worst type of person?
It would put you up there. Yeah.
The stealing fruit thing is just too much for me.
That's where I draw the line.
So. Rowan, can I ask you something?
I got nothing better to do, absolutely.
How badly do you want to get out of here?
Honestly, pretty badly. I think this air isn't good for me. My brain is very woozy right now.
Can I ask you what your skills are?
Oh Jesus. I seem
not to
give
me
take...
the exact skills, just like the general area of what you do.
Yeah, I seem to take a second. I'm sorry, I'm not sure, but I'm pretty sure I'm here to protect people. That's what
protect
I do.
Protect people from what exactly?
Harm, I would suppose.
Protect people from harm by harming others.
Well, that seems kind of counterproductive.
Well, I can't really get a good look at this place, but are you able to tell me what else is in this little building here?
So, Lucy, since we've gotten to know each other already, I have a little something to tell you. I have no idea what this place is, and also I am pretty sure I don't know any other places either. I have no idea where I am.
Well, that doesn't help a damn bit, does it?
No, it does not.
Well, I guess you can just follow my lead then.
All right, you lead. And we'll talk about that criminal stuff later. I think you have to change your ways a little bit.
So you're one of those types, is that it?
I'm gonna get along with Matif just fine.
So going back to looking around, this time using the dark vision from my belt, can I see what else is in here? It's up to 60 feet if that...
Sure, make another perception check. Okay, wrong one.
That is a 15.
15. You can see that there is somebody lying down. You're not sure whether they're dead or just unconscious in one of these center cages. You can also see that there is a guard on this opposite side. You can see the bars here, but you cannot see who is behind them.
The bracelet that's on my wrist, what is it made out of? And does it look breakable?
You can certainly try.
I look over to Rowan. Does Rowan have another bracelet as well?
You look at her, and she does not appear to have a matching bracelet.
What you looking at?
Nothing. And I'm going to go over to the stone wall, and I'm going to give a few good whacks at it with the bracelet to see what happens.
Make a unarmed strike.
Oh no.
With your huge plus two hit. Yeah. You can attack against the wall.
Oh my god. How am I gonna miss this wall here? 16.
Yep. Roll damage.
Zero.
So this is what happens when your strength is zero, right? Actually it's minus one. So you actually heal the bracelet. I'm joking. You knock your bracelet against the stone walls, but it just makes a ringing sound like you do when you bash metal against stone. You don't appear to dent it or harm it in any way.
And I'll go over to Rowan. You know, I don't know how strong you are, but you want to see if you can take this off of me?
Sure, no problem. I was wondering why you were hitting the wall. This is a very calming that you were trying to get this off. Anyway, let me try that. Should I do a strength check? I would like to grab his bracelet.
Sure, make an unarmed strike.
Can I try to, pull it apart? Is that also just a strike?
Sure.
All right. Da, 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 da,
da. yeah, that definitely hits. So I believe even if you roll damage, I think it's only a four. Still just four. But you grab Lucy's... It's essentially a bangle. And you begin to heave, and you can see, now that you're up close, Lucy, this chick's fucking jacked, man.
And she takes my arm off.
She begins to, like, pull this bracelet apart, and it gives you just a second to slip your hand out before it snaps back to its original shape.
Ooh! It worked!
Come off. And I tell her to shh. Not so loud.
I put one hand in front of my mouth.
Alright, so, Go ahead.
I was just about to kick in the door, but I think that's gonna be loud.
You were just gonna kick in the door and do what? Just fight everyone off?
I don't know. It's the first thing I could think of.
Well, I was gonna say it's kind of badass, but do you actually think you could do that?
Hey, there's only one way to find out, right? And I walk up to the door and I would like to kick it, even though it's iron.
Sure, make another unarmed strike against the door.
I'm glad we have another door kicker in this group now.
Oh, no! Natural one. So as you go to kick the iron bars, your leg goes through the bars, and you become stuck in between your bars and yourself.
Ow! Shit! Ah, goddammit! Ow! I just keep swearing and trying to get my foot back out.
And what are the guards doing at this point?
At this point, the guards, what the bloody hell is going on here? And he begins to walk back.
Nothing, we're just dancing. What? Yeah.
She seems to have gotten her foot stuck.
Yeah, can you bloody help see us that. Out here?
Help. Right, this is very uncomfortable.
He goes over and begins to... You can hear him muttering under his breath. Yeah, why the fuck do I get these shifts? These are the worst. I always have to deal with
these. Does he have any...
Is he? Sorry.
Lucy.
Does he have any keys? Or
he does have a set of keys jangling at his side.
Okay.
Does he have a sword?
He does. He has a great sword that is at his side. It is sheathed currently.
So he's got his hands on my foot?
Yeah, he's like got his hands and he's trying to like push you back in.
Alright, I would like to give a bit of resistance so my foot doesn't immediately go back into the cell.
Yep.
I would really like to pull his sword out of his sheath.
Sure, make a stealth check. So that
actually, as she does this,
mm-hmm.
Can I, I'd like to wink at Rowan and cast silence, if that's possible.
Oh, okay. Okay, you cast silence. Make your stealth check with advantage, Rowan.
Oh my gosh. Okay. Wait, how do I do advantage again?
Just roll it twice. Excellent. If you just roll it twice, it should be fine. Hi.
Ooh.
17.
As if... Well, actually, you do have disadvantage, but that's still a 17 because of your plate armor.
Okay. Yeah.
So the advantage makes it just a straight roll. as if you were born to stealth, Rowan.
Which I'm not.
Silence falls around you and the guard as he's attempting to break you out. And he notices something is wrong, but not immediately. As you pull his greatsword... from his side.
And instead of stabbing him, I would like to grab the back of his head and bang it against the iron doors.
Oh, since it's... Yeah, ooh. Go for it.
How sick is that?
Make an unarmed strike. That's rad.
Let's go!
21.
Oh, fuck yeah, roll damage. Ooh. That's... Yes, 100%. and then I'll give you... It'll be an extra d4 banging against the iron. Whoops. Yep, so
I think I accidentally did twice.
That's fine. Okay. It's the same
just
result.
Just bang his head twice against the
wall. You bang his head twice against the wall.
I do have two attacks on one turn, so I could do it twice.
If you want to do it again, go for it.
Oh my god.
Yes, I do want to do it again. 24.
Yes.
Yes. Huh, I have luck with my 1d4s today.
Oh my lord. Okay. You bang his head twice against the bars, which makes no sound because of the silent spell. And he falls unconscious to the ground.
Oh!
Awesome. Okay, I take my foot out because it's not stuck at all anymore.
Yeah.
And I... Oh, wait, you can't hear me speak because it's silent. I take the jangly keys that are very quiet and I unlock my door.
You unlock your door and saunter through as if nothing were wrong.
I would like to pull the guard along.
Okay.
Open Lucy's door. And kind of hold the guard towards him as if to say, put his clothes on, maybe that's a good idea.
Okay. Then I'll drop the silence and I will don the clothes of the guard.
Sure, you put on
the
guard's outfit. Although I just realized I put the wrong guards in, but they do have purple fabric that kind of flows from their armor, much like in the token, which is the color, obviously, of the Diplomatica. So you are now disguised as a guard. What would you like to do?
I go up and say, you know, that was pretty fucking badass, I will say.
Why, thank you. I was very surprised that that worked, honestly.
And so, that actually gives me a good idea. How about if we kind of play our way through this? I'll pretend to be transferring you to maybe another prison or something, and then we try to get out of here.
Ooh, yes! That I prefer that to beating up people, honestly. I think I've made a very bad first impression.
I think it was the best first impression someone could have made. But we should get our story straight before we try this. So I will be is there a name tag on the on this thing?
Yes, there is there's a little badge, a magnetic badge that's attached to his armor. It says Ronald.
Oh no.
Is his last name Weasley?
No, it's Wesley.
Last name McDonald.
Wesley Snipes.
Well, I'll be Ronald. And you will still be Rowena.
Yes.
And you are being transferred to a high security facility. How does that sound?
Because I'm incredibly dangerous.
Yeah, we'll go with that.
Hell yeah.
And how good that you are at kind of playing around like this.
Oh, very bad. I am not a good actor.
Okay. Well, let me do the talking if you don't mind then.
All right, gotcha. I'll just make scared faces and from time to time just try to run away.
Oh, great. You do whatever you feels right. So, can we move our pieces?
Yeah, you should be able to.
Cool. And then I'd just like to... Oh. So yeah, just follow me.
All right.
And then
gosh.
I'll head over to this cell and see who this is.
You look inside and it appears to be a human woman with flaming red hair. Seems to be fucking pissed. You can see she's drooling a lot. She smells of liquor, even at this distance.
Is she... How do I say this? Is she, like, totally out of it and doesn't know what's going on?
She's unconscious.
Oh, she's unconscious. Can I see the other guard from here?
Yeah, he can see you. You can see him. And as you actually get to that distance, he begins to walk over.
Alright. While he's walking over, can I cast Minor Illusion to make a sound?
Sure, where?
The part that's kind of below us, right across from the window, is that a hallway that leads to somewhere else?
Here?
Yes.
Yes, it is.
Can I cast a Minor Illusion sound there of Ronald speaking, since I heard his voice? That's
sure.
Possible.
Even though he can see you.
Okay, he can see me?
Yeah. Look, he's... Yeah.
Okay.
He has direct
if he can see
eyeline.
Me, then I'll... Then, Yeah, actually, I'll still cast it. If I can cast it sneakily without him seeing.
That's fine. As he's walking over, you cast it. What sound do you make?
Just Ronald saying, I need some help over here. Or is that possible?
Yeah, that's fine. Sure.
Okay.
The guard looks at you, looks to the sound.
I've got you, Ronald. I'm coming.
Begins to run up these stairs here.
All right, and then we'll run over to the other side of this the
you
little prison.
Over.
Who
you,
else is in these other cells?
You look in and you see a very familiar looking bronze. Is he copper? Copper. Please, he's a copper. Copper dragonborn. Shirtless, wearing a puka shell necklace, wearing a pair of board shorts, no shoes. He looks up at you, he's like,
whoa, are we doing a fucking jailbreak? Fucking radical. Let's go.
Yeah, well, well, look who it is. And I'm going to throw him back his surfboard that he gave me.
You don't have a surfboard. You have don't have
I don't have a surfboard.
You don't have your no. You would have your weapons okay. Would have been taken away. So your shields and your weapon.
So I look over to Rowena, Amesh, Rowena, Amesh.
Excuse me, what?
You look in and you see this.
The dragon in there is Amesh.
Look in and so you see this dragonborn fellow.
Hello, I am Rowan. I immediately walk over and want to shake his hand.
He shakes your hand.
Whoa, that's fucking rad, man. Are we getting out of this jail cell? I was caught
smoking
pot on a boat again, man. It's just... It's not a good vibes. Fuck.
That's a crime. Is he a good guy?
Yeah, he's much better than me.
Oh!
An old friend.
Oh, we really have to talk later. All right, I unlock the door for Amesh.
Whoa, that's fucking rad. Thanks, man.
And he just walked out.
So
Lucy,
I'll give him the
my
quick
dude.
Details. Yeah, I'll give him a hug.
Guys over and hugs you.
And
you
probably
can...
squishes my spine.
You can smell the weed even at this distance.
Oh god. Yeah, well, on the quick story, Rowan and I are breaking out of here. I am Ronald, as you can see, and we are getting the fuck out of here. But let me do the talking, okay?
Not a problem, man. I can talk, like, whenever you need. I'm like a trained actor, you know? Like, what? Crazy.
That's incredible.
Also, before we go, do you know the way out of here, Amesh?
Dude, I don't know how I woke up on a beach on the eastern shores of Arun, like, 5 years ago, man. Just one moment, I'm on a pub crawl through Markovia, the next moment I'm in Arun, it's just a blur, man. I don't know how I got here. But what I can tell you is that I've got your back.
Alright, well, thank you very much. It's nice to see you.
Yeah, you too, man.
And then, actually, is this place above us also to a hallway?
There is a door. Yeah.
Oh, that's a door.
Yes.
I'm starting to feel really bad because he seems to have to carry this whole team right now.
What do you mean? I'm a great team member. I can take one for the squad, you know?
That won't be necessary. What do you guys think? Through the door or through the hall?
Whatever you think is best, Brochacho.
I think the hall would make more sense to be connected to the outside. But it would also have more people.
Well, let's go with your decision. You seem to be doing really well today, so let's go ahead.
Ah, thank you. Oh, wait, I'm seeing these grates in the prison cells?
Yeah, they're just...
Are those real?
Yeah, they're part of the stonework, but they're very thin slits. They're not, like, tunnels or anything.
All right. Well, never mind. Let's go.
Yeah, it was a good idea.
Oh, thank you.
It's just here as he's a little big, so.
What do you mean, man? I'm average sized for my for my clan.
This is big boned.
Yeah, man, you know what? Good for you.
Yeah, thanks, man. I appreciate it. Radical.
Yeah, can we see further down this hall?
Yeah, you look further down the hall, and you can hear commotion. Down the other end of the hall, you don't see a light. It doesn't, the path, the tunnel, sorry, doesn't seem to lead upwards. It just seems to lead straight.
And how long is this hallway?
You look down it with your dark vision. You can see that there are several torches, but it seems to curve to the left at a point, in which you can't see anymore.
All right, what do you think, Rowan? Keep on going or try the door?
I hate that these look like... This looks like a labyrinth. Let's take a peek-see through the door.
We will head over to the door.
Whoa, a change of plans? Completely expected. Oh, nice.
Is it a wooden door?
Yeah, it's just a wooden door.
And unlike Lucy, he will open it with his hands.
Yep, you turn the handle and it's not locked. It just opens and swings into some sort of antechamber with three more doors.
So many doors.
Even more labyrinth. You know, if we keep left all the time, we'll get out eventually, but we'll also clear out this whole place and I think that'll get us in trouble.
Are there any... you know how, like, buildings have kind of maps showing where everything is.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Are there any of those?
Make a perception check.
And I also let everyone know what I'm trying to do, so if they can help me.
Yeah, I would like to help.
Yeah, man, I'll help you look for a map. And he turns around and like looks into the empty room. But you can rule with advantage because Rowan is helping.
So, Lucy rolled an 8.
You have advantage, because Rowan is helping.
Okay, cool.
Ooh.
21.
As you enter, right here is a little, like, sign that says, Welcome! what would it be? Welcome to the Diplomatic Forum Dungeons. Your stay is greatly appreciated. It does seem to be a little bit torn up, though. And you see that it's been scratched out with the, instead of Diplomatic Forum, it's been replaced with the West Awa Company Dungeons.
Huh, seems kind of passive-aggressive, I don't know.
Yeah. And
but,
this didn't have a map on it?
Yes. There's a door to your left, which takes you into a large room, which has a storage chamber to the bottom. Can you guys see when I do this, even with the...
Yeah, we can just see the pings.
Yep. So there's a big room here, a little room here. There's a big room here, little room here, like storage rooms. There is a very large room here, another large room up here, and another large room here.
Alright, well, I ain't no, you know, smarty pants, but one of or our gear might be in some of these smaller rooms. Probably think it's worth fetching. What do you think?
Yeah, let's go. Wait, should I knock? No, I don't. No, we're sneaking. I just, yeah. I think, normally open the door.
Yeah.
Okay.
Maybe I open the door first.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You open the door, and immediately see a guard eating some soup. He has a bowl, and he's got a spoon to his face, and he looks up as he sees three prisoners enter.
Hey, friend, my name is Ronald, and I'm a new guard here. I'm kind of lost. Could you help me out?
Make a deception check.
I'm speechless at how effortless that lie was.
That was an 8.
He puts down his bowl of soup and draws his sword.
When he does that, can I cast Charm Person?
Sure. What kind of save is that?
Wisdom 15.
Yeah, no. You see a haze come over his eyes.
Right. So, look at his name tag. What's his name?
I always go to Jeffrey, but I've already had a couple of Jeffreys. let's go with James.
James, my good friend. It's been a while since we've seen each other.
It's nice to see you, man. I haven't seen you in a while.
Yeah, so as you can see, we're taking these two prisoners, you know, these bad motherfuckers, and we're transferring them to another prison. But we need to find their gear and also the way out of here, because, you know, I had a lot to drink last night, and it's kind of fuzzy right now, so. You think you can help us out?
That's not a problem, man. Their gear is just in this room here. Crazy.
And he points to this door here.
Just through there.
Great, great.
Amazing.
We'll open the door and go inside.
All of your gear's there. You can also see that Amesh has a new surfboard.
Oh, nice.
As opposed to his red and white surfboard that he gave to you, which actually you do see in this room, because it's with your weapons, Lucy. Mm. Yeah, you see his new kind of blue and red. The blue surfboard with red stripes.
So, I will take the gear.
You get your normal stuff back. Rowan, you do find your shield and your sword.
Oh, home sweet home, I say, and I kind of cuddle my shield like an old friend. Okay, I'm ready. I sheath my crystal sword, and I still have the great sword of the guard in my hand. Do you want that?
No, I can't really use that. It's a little heavy for me.
Okay, I just check it aside.
Clank, clank, clank.
So I... I look over at...
Sorry.
Look over at James. So yeah, how's the friends and family?
Well, you know, my husband, you know, he's having a great time at the moment. He's working at the store, doing it, living his best life, you know. It's going really well for him.
Great, great. Do I have any gold on me?
Yeah, you got your stuff.
Alright. Can I give him a piece of gold and say, here's for the husband?
Aw, shucks, you didn't have to do that, but thank you.
Yeah, and would you tell us the way out of here?
Well, yeah, there's the, there's the main entrance, and points back to where you guys came from.
But the quick way is just through the big chamber. You know the one. It's the one up here.
All right. And who's on duty today in the big chamber?
I think it's Ben.
Ben. I see. Well, it was nice seeing you again, and say hi to the husband for me, will you?
Will do.
And so we will head over to the big chamber.
Aww. Amesh, Amesh grabs his shield, his surfboard, which he then straps to his arm like a shield. And he grabs his warhammer, which is a huge conch shell on the end of a stick. and you lead the way into the main chamber. I will reveal that for you right now.
Were you saying something wrong?
Yeah, and you were pretending you were a bad person. That was adorable.
Well, I do got a soft spot for some people. And as we go into the main chamber, I'll say, hey, Ben, how's it going?
Hey, how's it going, man? And he looks at you, and he looks at your name tag. Make a deception check.
Can I help him by being very scared of the soldier?
Sure.
Awesome.
You ooh-woo, thank and you're you so like, much for I'm that. So scared. Roll it.
Wow. Ah. What do you want?
He looks at the ooh-wooing tiefling paladin. Yeah, man, that's not a problem. You okay? Goodbye. Okay.
Yep. I'm so helpless.
Oh my god. Oh, well, I'm so helpless. Well, not the best.
I'm so scared.
Please don't help. Hurt me.
Please don't hurt me.
Oh, how lucky is chat today? How lucky is chat today?
Oh, we need to make that a sound right. Redeem. Oh, my Lord.
Well, it's before just... we get distracted, we'll go ahead and head on out of here.
Alrighty. You head to the main door, and make your way through the hidden pathway.
The hidden Ooh. Pathway.
As you do, Sacred as you make, tunnel. As you guys make it to about here, you do hear Xandros's voice from around here. Yell out to Ben.
Oh, he just yells out to him. He doesn't say anything else.
Yeah, he's Yeah, Ben, come over here, man. I've got something for you to do quickly. Need some papers signed.
Okay. And then in this hidden room, what do we see?
It's literally a path that goes directly upwards.
Okay. I'll look back to Rowan and Amesh. So, we all good to go here? Seems like this might be the way out.
Yeah, let's go! Ooh, prison break!
Yep, and then we'll go out.
Well, that's the second time in a week that I've prison breaked. Fucking gnarly, man.
And you guys...
Tell us that story.
Yeah, look, so I was dancing with these girls on a yacht.
Oh, no, anyways, not right now.
You guys exit out of the hashtag jail cell, and we will cut back to Emeth, Dante, and Matif as they walk out of the Awa Republic, not Awa Republic, the West Awa Company.
Matif is just muttering to himself about how this goddamn idiot, holy fuck, can't he just take a hit? God, fuck.
You know what, I'm going to agree with you on this time. You've got to be fucking kidding me. You know what? We're lucky that I have really nice tits. Just, it's true.
Latif just gives the okay symbol and then continues.
Yeah, exactly. Don't say you haven't noticed, okay?
A random guy walking past goes, hey, they're pretty nice. And continues walking.
Thank you. See, I can get recognition around here if I wanted.
Is that really the kind of recognition you want?
Oh, I'm a whore for attention.
Any recognition is good recognition in my books.
Anyway, what the fuck are we gonna do?
I don't know. Well, we're not going back to the hotel. I take it we're going back to my newly acclaimed house.
Well, I feel like we have to be ready for when someone comes to talk to us.
I know, but... We don't really have time. We need to go back and prepare to leave. We need to leave the city. ASAP, really. I was hoping we could spend the night at least and then leave first thing tomorrow morning, but... Or we...
I mean, that's a smart decision, honestly.
Yeah. Or we could be lawful about it, which I don't favor, but, you know, we could do what we did last time. Did we pay bail last time? I don't remember what happened.
Yes, we did, and he still hasn't paid me back for
it. Oh, don't worry, sweetie. We'll
pay for someone's freedom, and they don't pay you back.
Oh, don't. Look, it's fine. Well, you'll be rich one day, all right? I know it.
But I don't give a shit about that. I just... You do something nice for someone, they should pay in kind. That's how the world works.
Sorry. I've watched Inside, like, a million times. Anyways, continue.
Anyway, not the point. The point is, we have two options here, I believe. Is to ditch him, which honestly doesn't feel that bad right now, after all the trouble that we're in, because of him not being able to fucking take a hint.
Or second option.
We fucking pay the bail again, get us out of the situation. Because, think about it, like, we don't really want to go up against a whole thingy. You know what I mean.
Okay, can we even afford it? Can we afford it? How much do we have?
We could take out a payday loan.
Is there a bank nearby?
Make an investigation check.
I
mean, I have more money this time than I did.
Oh, I do too. Yeah, it's fine.
Although for a second offense, fuck no. I have no clue.
You see a really shady guy on a street corner with a sign that says bank. That seems to be hand carved.
Can I make an insight check?
Sure.
Oh my god.
That's a 13.
You've taken you've like bought drugs from people like this. Probably not a great move. Oh, you've at least probably seen people buy drugs from people like this. Probably not a smart move to give them your money.
Yeah. Okay. But for a second offense, it's probably more expensive.
Well, we don't know. He could be trying to get out right now. And then, well.
God, that's such a fucking bad idea.
No,
why would he do something like that?
He's made plenty of bad ideas, I have no doubt.
Well, no shit!
Probably planning something right now. Which is then, like, if this was a movie, it would cut back to him just being chaotic as shit.
We cut inside and we see... We cut back inside and we see Rowan... This is the point where Rowan is, like, pulling his, like, electric bracelet apart.
Bashing it in.
we could kind of ask him what he's doing.
What do you mean?
Did I ever explain that I can write messages to Lucy?
Did he explain that? I don't remember.
Did you explain this to us?
I don't think you explained it to them.
I might have forgotten that then. He sort of like shrugs a bit and looks down.
What do you mean you can write look, there's no... I don't think a postman's going down into the dungeons. What do you mean write
to Lucy? I don't quite know how it works, but it's magic. It's magic.
Magic.
And it's I'm just gonna like open my spell book and write just a really simple message, just like, where are you and what are you doing? and you cast sending.
This is at the point, Lucy, where you guys are. This is the point where Rowan is bashing in the head of this guy against the against the bars. And because of how silence works, you cannot respond to the sending spell.
Do I hear his message, though?
You can hear his message, though.
Okay.
You send the message, Dante, but you get no response.
Hmm.
But you do know that the, you do know that the message was received.
Is there, like, a reply time?
Yeah.
Where I have to reply.
Yeah. You do know, you know that, sorry, because of how the sending spell works, you know when it isn't received, right? But
I don't think it mentions anything about that.
I believe it does. What I remember, or am I misremembering? Sending, 5e.
Yeah, I don't think it's, yeah, it doesn't specifically mention that I know if it's arrived.
Doesn't have a red option, apparently.
Yeah. I will have it so that you know if the spell doesn't hit.
Cool.
It does hit.
Hmm.
So.
And left unread, what do you think of that?
Dante just looks at the paper for a second and just... I guess he's busy.
You know what, that's enough of an answer for me. Yeah, he's definitely trying to break out.
Yeah. We should probably get some rest. I think we're gonna need to run.
Oh god, what time of day is it?
It's late afternoon at this point. Maybe 4 or 5 o'clock
it's
in the evening.
It's late afternoon. Well, so there's a few things we could do. I mean, we're still fucked up from today, which was a lot. We could rest, I suppose. Like, we could take a short rest. You know, depending on how much time it takes. I'm gonna guess the second, like, we catch up with Lucy that we're gonna have to bust out of here.
What I'm thinking is we should probably go to your mom's house and collect the documents.
Yeah, we'll go and grab everything we can, I suppose, and rest there for now.
Can I, quickly, do I see a magical aura around Emeth? Like, is there a curse?
Make an Arcana check.
Ooh.
An Astrid Arcana check?
Heart.
That's a 5. I rolled a 2!
No.
Hello.
There is an aura around Emeth, but you don't know if it's a curse or not.
That's fair.
She just kind of, you know, like, glows. Might be her skincare routine, you're not sure.
it's the salt water.
Exactly. Good for the skin.
Yeah, I suppose we should go back, try and rest up for what we can. Dante, maybe a little later on you send another message?
Yes, sounds good.
Yeah, maybe in another 10 minutes or so, just... I don't know.
That looks a little desperate, not gonna lie.
Well, Dante, you know what went through, right?
Yeah.
Okay, well then you send another one. Maybe he's not busy this time. This is literally just like how to text boys.
He left me on red, so I'm gonna reply with him. I'm gonna text him again in 10 minutes.
All I'm telling you, girl, is that if you do that, you're looking a little clingy.
Oh my god, you up?
I was about to say that fucking hey, you up. Holy shit, you not knocked unconscious anymore, babe.
Oh my god.
yeah, but what do you guys think? We should go and rest up, eat, and just grab everything we can and prepare to get out of here.
That sounds good.
I hate to say it, but that's probably our course of action with what we're dealing with.
Assuming that he's, you know, trying to break out right now, which I know I'm gonna assume he wouldn't enjoy just sitting there and dealing with the consequences to his own actions. God, yeah, the gods forbid he does that.
Eventually, all of you make your way to the the Kendall abode. I'm trying to find the last name. Found it, eventually.
Are
you sure about that? Where you see that there is a folded note that is tucked in between the door and the doorframe.
God. I will grab it and read it.
You see that it's a quick, it's a short note from Gustin. Basically saying, I know what's happened. I'm sorting it out with the president. I'm trying to get this all sorted out. Lay low. If you meet up with Lucy, get out of the city. Xandros has her wrapped around his finger.
Huh? Huh?
You can't ask a note questions. It's not gonna answer you.
Make an insight check against the note.
Yeah, I was gonna say, would Emmeth know who her is?
Sure.
Could be
probably the president, if I had to guess.
Oh, yeah, true. I'll think about that. Insight, it's a 9.
That could be anyone. Who is her? Is her a name? Wow.
Who is she?
Who is she?
Who is she?
Have I ever told a sidetrack the story of my biology teacher in Germany? So, in German, Frau and Herr are like the way to say Mr. and Mrs. In the opposite. Herr is Mr. and Frau is Mrs. So my biology teacher in Germany was called Frau Herr, and I couldn't for the life of me figure out what the fuck is going on. Anyway, sidetrack. So her being a name makes a lot of it. Yeah.
I love that.
Your name. Oh God, help.
Yeah. Anyway. So, you guys can take a short rest now that you're at the Kendall abode. What would you like to do during your short rest? Let's go around. Mateef, is there anything specifically you would like to do?
No, I don't. Other than short rest.
Other than short rest, nothing? Cool. Dante. Yeah. Is there anything you would like to do?
I'm gonna ping Lucy once more, but other than that, no.
Sure. What are you gonna write?
Just like, yeah, going with the assumption that he's breaking out, I'm just gonna ask, like, how's the breakout going?
As you are leaving up the exit, Lucy, you hear the message from Dante saying, "How is the breakout going?"
And so we're out of the jail, right?
Yes.
There's a limit on.
I believe
this
it
thing,
is
right?
25 words.
Yeah, 25 words.
Okay. Well, I just respond back. Hell is now empty, and the devils are coming. Where are you guys?
And I'll reply back with Emma's house.
And then we make our. I'll tell the Rowan and Amesh about it, and then we'll probably make our way over there.
Whoa, crazy Emma invested in real estate? That's a fucking smart move. Wow. Impressive.
That is a smart move. I was thinking about doing that too. Maybe. I don't know. Anyway, can I join you? I feel like I should follow you.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
I'm not sure yet. Let's find out.
All the best nights right. I've ever had are both good and bad. It's just how you balance out life. It's a bit like karma. You know what I'm saying?
He just goes on a rant.
God. And then as he's on the ramp, I guess we'll make our way over there. God. Listening to Amesh wax poetic.
Yeah, he talks about how he got really drunk on a yacht. ended up high-fiving a kraken, you know, all this crazy shit.
May I, on the way there, I seem to get a little quieter and seem to become a little more thoughtful. But I'm not really speaking much on my way there.
Cool. Emeth, what would you like to do during your short rest, other than short rest? You are in your childhood home.
Oh. So, like, I can do stuff, I don't just have to...
No, you don't just have to sit down. You can,
oh,
you
okay,
can do,
cool.
like, light activity, so you can, like, walk around and investigate and stuff. Oh.
You bet I'm gonna go straight to my mom's room.
Sure.
The mother's room.
You make it to the third floor. And you... The door is locked.
Do I... no, I don't know if I... How about lockpicking shit? No, I have thieves' tools.
Mm-hmm.
Is that like, can I use that to try and pick the lock?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
You are. Let me just.
Yeah, I'll give it a crack then.
Yep. So that's just dexterity plus proficiency, so it's +7 to lock picking.
Fucking hell. Okay. Wait. So just straight roll with the deck.
+7.
So it would be a D.
D20 +7.
Roll +4. Oh.
Plus proficiency.
What the hell's my proficiency? Oh, you're right. It is just a +7. Never mm-hmm. mind. Okay, here we go. Oh, wait. Shit. D20, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, maybe I had spaces and it didn't like that. No? Why isn't it working? Is it /R? D?
Well, roll. D. The word roll, space, D20 +7.
Oh, I think... Okay, hold on.
I'll send you the... I'll send you
no,
the
it's okay. I can do this. Okay.
There we are.
A 19.
19. Are you...
Oh, shit. No, that's wrong. Oh, fuck.
Oh, no. Yeah, that is incorrect.
It's... hold on.
Actually, an 11.
Oh, I thought, should I just roll it again? Or
yeah, just roll it again. That's fine.
Okay. Oh, fuck you. All right.
Okay, that's just what you needed.
Okay. Oh, you...
So, you take out your thieves' tools and very quickly manage to unlock the door to your mother's room.
You walk in and immediately can smell decay. You look around the room. You can see that there are manacles on the wall. Blood splattered everywhere. There's no bed. There is a bed up against the wall, like vertically. Along with like chains and ropes attached to the bed. And then various torture implements and other NSFW related things.
So I suppose we're looking at pleasure and pain here, right? Like a combo, like there's fucking blood everywhere, but at the same time it's like, ooh, a little cute whip. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But also like, I will rip your fingernails off kind of vibe.
Yeah.
Okay. Wow.
There is also a chest and like storage on the opposite side of the room.
Check that out.
Sure. You reach the chest, and it is locked.
Can I try to unlock this one?
Go for
it. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, let's go.
Let's fucking go, baby. It's a 12, shit.
You take your locks picks in and attempt to break the lock, but you can't seem to get the tumblers to click over.
I shoot the lock open.
Make an attack with your gun.
Yeah. Pew pew.
Sure, that hits. Roll damage. 14.
Ignore the sneak attack, I guess.
So 5 damage, sure. You point your gun at the lock, blast it open, the lock falls apart. Dante Matif, you hear a gunshot from upstairs.
It's fine. Just me, don't worry about it. Just yell down so they know, like, it's fine, yeah, don't worry, yeah.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. I'll look in the chest.
Sure. You open up the chest and you see a clay jar. Doesn't seem to be too big. Maybe like a thin, like a vase. Like vase, like sized, but it's a clay jar. The top is sealed. Inside you see that there are fine, very, very fine robes, along with a silver crown with leaf motifs. And that is all you seem to see in this chest.
Right. So there's some nice ass robes.
Mm-hmm.
Like, would they fit me? How big are they?
Sure, you take them out and they seem to be similarly sized to you. Like, not as if it was made for me, but it's, you know, you would fit, sure.
Like, they're not tiny, like halfling size or
no,
shit?
No, they're not halfling sized.
No. And there's a crown in there, you say?
Yes, there is like a sorts. Less of a crown, like more of like a tiara.
Like a headpiece. Yeah. A little headpiece, yeah. Is it like gold?
I said just before it was silvered.
Sorry.
That's all right.
I'll take it. It's pretty and shiny, so.
Oh.
Is that everything in there?
Yep.
And is there everything in the room as well?
Make an investigation check.
Okay. Investigation. Oh, it's an 11.
11. You go to the chest of drawers and it just appears to be your Del Noah's. Like
clothes and other, like, various knickknacks. Even with an 11, you do find 200 platinum.
Oh, fucking... Let's go!
Your mom was a pirate, dude. You left, just left money lying around. But that's all you find with an investigation of 11.
I see. And I'll probably go down to my old childhood room and, probably just go and try and lay on my bed. Well, you know, yeah. And chill out in there and just think.
Cool. You guys finish your short rest, before eventually, Lucy, Rowan, and Amish make their way to the front door.
Yeah, so, before I introduce you, Rowan, just know that we're a little bit, weird.
Weird? So, this is intriguing. I'm very interested.
That reminds me, that's what the Jarl called me after I sold him some, like, top-notch dragon grass, right? So, picture this.
Oh, by the way, the door, we would have locked, or I would have made sure... that the doors to the house were locked and shit.
Sure.
If I hear anyone knock on the door or approach or like turn the handle or shit, like I'll have my gun at the ready.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if I come back downstairs and stuff and yeah.
Sure. You mm-hmm. hear a knock on the door from Lucy?
Yeah, so as you were saying, we've got a weird group. Obviously, you met Amish.
Yo, that's me, man.
I feel like that speaks for itself. We have a little wooden halfling. We got a very dangerous but very beautiful half-elf pirate. And we also got a... What's that guy's name? Oh, well, you'll meet him soon enough.
I swear to fucking God, I will punch a bitch! I will punch a bitch!
Yurisa, do you remember when you were asking why Mateef and Lucy were like in that fist fight?
Holy shit!
I will punch!
I see.
I mean, I won't, because I'll take the higher ground.
It's Mateef from the future walks past in the background. Like, I swear to fuck.
I swear to fuck.
Oh my god.
Ooh. I seem rather eager to meet them.
Yeah. And, well, you've already met me, the... yeah. We'll
the scoundrel later, so. Who's actually kind of nice. Yeah.
We'll see about that. Knock on the door again.
I guess I'll get it.
You go over, you unlock the like 8 locks on this door.
Why did you lock all of these?
Portions, what? Why else? Just fucking open it. I'll, like, you know, have my gun at the ready.
Yep, I open it.
And there you see Lucy, Amish, and a tiefling at the door.
Amish!
Hey, what's up, brah? Nice to see you. He pushes past Lucy and Rowan, comes in, gives you a big bear hug, Mateef.
And then we do the handshake that we've definitely come up with before, yes. And that I'm not making up right now.
No, definitely. the super special handshake, yep.
Yeah,
Amish.
That one.
Amish, what are you doing here?
So, I was on this yacht, right?
You know what? save it for later. I'm sure I'd love to hear what's up. What happened to you?
Oh, that's my favorite song.
Like,
that's a joke. Stop. Only somebody who would know Amish's Spotify would get. Very
wow,
niche
by
joke.
the four non-white dragons.
Mm-hmm, yep.
Lucy, you're back.
Yeah, well, no small thanks to, what I assume is my new friend here, Rowan. Rowan, this is the group.
I wave a little awkwardly. Hello.
I'm gonna walk over to her and get probably to an uncomfortable closeness. Like, probably our noses are like an inch from each other, and I'm just kind of staring at her dead in the eyes.
Are we about to kiss?
I kind of cock my head to the side. Like, I mean, I mean, shit. I mean, if that's up to you. So.
Hi, I'm Rowan. I hold my hand out to her.
Emeth. So, I'm guessing you guys met in jail?
Yeah, that doesn't put me in the best light, does it?
Oh, no, trust me, I've met many people who... many, wonderful person, who I've met in jail, funnily enough, so...
Oh, you've been to jail too? Is the entire group like that?
No, not
everyone. Totally.
Oh my god.
No.
Oh. Well, you seem fun.
Oh, I suppose. Thank you very much. That is nice to hear. Who? Where are the other people I've heard about?
Oh.
What other people?
I think she's referring to you.
I'm literally right here.
Yeah. Say hi.
Jeez. Hi, I'm Rowan. I heard about a wood person.
Oh no, that's the short one. This one, right here, with the antlers.
Oh, down there! Oh my gosh, yeah. Hello!
Oh my god!
Oh my god!
I feel like I'm not making a good first impression. Hello, welcome! What? No, hi, I'm Rowan. I look through the group and checking everyone's faces, and my energy seems to drop a little bit, like I get sad or something, and I reach my hand out to everyone.
Are you offering something?
No, this is a handshake.
Do they do handshakes differently in wherever you're from?
I will shake her hand apprehensively.
And I nudge Dante forward, since he hasn't introduced himself.
Yeah, come on. Say something.
And Dante just sort of looks at Rowan and looks away and looks back and sort of just tries to... It's just sort of really awkward with a new person. Hi, I'm Dante. Nice to meet you.
Hi. I hunker down, thinking that's a nice thing to do, and hold out my hand.
And yeah, Dante shakes the hand.
Nice to meet you, Dante.
Yeah.
Don't let him fool. I'm kill you, by the way.
Oh.
No, I won't.
I like how he just talked over Mateep.
That's canon to
me. I'm Mateep, by the way.
You're not gonna lie.
What did you say, Pastel?
I said very in character.
Oh, no, the... before that.
I said, that... my name is Mateep. Like, forgetting that he hadn't actually introduced himself yet.
Oh. It's nice to meet you, Mateep. I didn't want to pry. I felt like that was... We're not at that stage in our relationship yet.
What?
Of knowing names.
Oh. Okay.
She's so awkward.
Now that
oh my
you've
god.
Met everyone.
Rowan.
Yeah, so now that we met everyone, you mind, well, actually, you never remembered anything about yourself. Does anything come back to you?
The, sad expression seems to get a little more, pronounced. I just kind of thought it was like the stale air in the prison or something. I know that my name is Rowan, and I know I have to find somebody, but I have no idea who that is, and I thought, I kind of thought it would be one of you. I'm sorry. But it doesn't seem so.
When she says that, Lucy takes a note of that and remembers the pink jolt or spark of electricity. But he'll keep it to himself for now.
Lucy will remember this.
Oh my god. Me and Pascal are just on that level.
Yeah, but it's been a long day. Seems like you guys have got a good safe house here. Maybe we can rest for the night. What do y'all think?
I'm dying to sleep.
Fuck, what's his name? It's not Gaston.
Gustin.
Gustin. Okay,
I'm just imagining. Sorry. Oh my god, I'm just imagining a 2.5-foot Gaston now. Oh my god.
Stop.
I was thinking the big himbo Gustin.
Yes. Oh my god, we need crossover merch now.
Disney X VTuber table.
Let's make it happen.
Gustin said to leave the city as quick as possible.
He also did say to lay low and that he was speaking with the president.
Yeah, but he also said that the president is wrapped around his finger.
True, but the thing is, will anyone know where to even find us? We did say we were at the Dragonfire Inn, and we're certainly not there. Oh, well. You know, maybe you were right. Maybe we should just fight to get out of the city, because I'm sure it won't be long before they notice that, well, they're not in jail.
And then there's just a siren that goes over the city. Wee-wee!
Prisoners escaped!
Prisoners escaped. No.
Yeah, well, maybe the best idea is to lay low for tonight, but actually, does your mom still have her old ship? Would you know?
No. Wait, did you tell me about that?
Yeah, you were there when they read the letters.
I had to
translate.
I fucking was like, hey, I can't read this bit. It's in a language I don't speak. Can you read it? And then you just saw it. And so I don't know how you feel. You haven't been vocal about it.
Oh. No, I'm not stepping on that ship to save my life.
You say that?
Yeah.
Someone well, a bit how else are we gonna get out of here?
I don't fucking know, but we're not going on that ship.
Well, why not? It seems like a very plausible way to get out of here.
Because
a resource that we can use.
That's the ship that killed my crew. I'm not getting on.
Wait, stop. What?
Did I not make sense? That they slaughtered...
No. Hey, no, it fucking made sense, but... You didn't... Why didn't you say anything?
Well, it wasn't prevalent.
Delnoa.
The Nala.
The Nala? Oh.
Yeah, that... They sunk us. I'm not getting on that ship.
Okay. I'm sorry, I didn't know.
I think kind of exasperatedly, he's like, it's fine. Kind of like, one of those signals, like, we're gonna stop talking about this now. It's pretty obvious.
Yeah. Well, I think we should just rest first and clear our minds. It has been a very physically and emotionally long day for all of us. Lots of new things we're learning. And then starts to kind of just dissociate into the back wall.
Yeah. Your mom's a demon.
She's not even my mom. And just thinking about all the lore that got dropped. And then I'll kind of snap myself out of it. There's plenty of bedrooms here. I'm sure there's definitely room for all of us to stay. I mean, shit, make yourself at home. You know?
You worried they're gonna put up barricades for us tomorrow? I mean, it's not gonna take them long.
If they find out we're here, you mean, yeah?
No, I mean, like, to get out of the city, they might set up, What is it when they, like, check your ID at the...
Checkpoints?
Thank you.
There's no way we could... No. I don't know magic. We can't just, like, teleport out of here or something, can we? Do we know people that can do that?
I don't think we know anyone strong enough. Because Dim Door is like a 5th level spell.
Yeah. Well.
Don't quote me on that, by the way. I don't know. I was making shit up. I don't know.
Is this Dimension Door or Teleport?
Yeah, Dimension Door is what
dimension
I was thinking.
Door is like, I believe, 4th level. Teleport is like 7th.
If only we had, like, high-level spellcasters.
If only we knew one that was in, like, a dream sequence that was, like, real short and had, like, frog-like features. If only we had someone that was, like, connected to a really powerful druid of sorts, that'd be real rad.
I don't know if it's on the druid spell list.
Well, there's other ways. There's, like, teleport via plants.
Damn. Anyways, well, I don't know if they do checkpoints at docks, you know, boat, if they do set them up, I don't, boat, you know, by boat, or by ship, might be our only way out of here, we'll have to see. But I think we should rest, we'll see what the situation is like in the morning. What do we think?
Yeah, maybe we need a quick night to think about everything that's happened.
Yeah. Amish, it's good to see you back. And, welcome, I guess?
Sorry, real quick. You see that Amish has already walked over to the fireplace, lit his, lit a blunt over the fire in the fireplace, and is already
Fuck's
smoking.
Sake.
The man never changes.
Oh, yes. But
well,
yeah,
dudes, you can change the city, but you can't change the dudes.
You know what? Okay, thanks, Amish. But anyways, make yourself at home, Rowan.
Oh. That is kind.
Yeah, this is technically my house now, since it was my, well, not mom's, but she was turned out to be a demon, and so she kind of, we kind of killed her, but she didn't really, but now technically this house is mine. Yeah, enjoy. And then I'll, you know, start to walk off and start to, you know, take off, like, my fucking corset and whatever my cloak and whatever I'm wearing on top. Yeah, and, you know, my gloves. You know, halfway up the stairs, I'll be like, yeah, Lucy, I'm glad you're okay. And then, kind of flustered, I just kind of go upstairs and I'll go to my bedroom, which I'm guessing is pretty safe.
Yeah, got a sick bed, maybe.
So, all of you find your places for the night? The rest?
Before we go to sleep.
Yes, of course, Lucy wants to do something. Am I surprised? No.
But if anyone wants to go first before I
sure. Let's start with Mr. Dante. Do you want to do anything?
Dante is very overwhelmed by the content of the day and needs to chill.
Sure.
You want to smoke that blunt with a match?
No, he will be chilling sober.
Matif, is there anything you would like to do?
No.
Rowan, is there anything you would like to do?
I would love to hang out with Amish for the rest of the evening.
Sure.
Oh, I want to see what the hell he's doing, because I have no idea.
Sure. You see that he is currently smoking weed. He's just lying back in like a...
The dragon grass.
He's laying back in like this almost like lazy boy leather chair. just lying back, taking like long, deep breaths from his blunt. But anyways, as I was talking about, so I was on this yacht with this like really rich dude. I can't remember his name, but we
that
were
happens
like,
a lot.
Yeah, it seems to happen to me all the fucking time. Like I just walk onto a beach, up on a yacht, and just sail away. Like it just happens, man.
Yeah.
But anyways, I found myself in the Prismatic Isles. I don't know how much longer I can improv that. but Amesh will just continue to talk about his various exploits for as long as you will listen.
Amazing. I will just fall asleep at like 2 a.m. or something.
Sure.
From the secondhand smoke in there.
Alrighty. Pass it back to you then, Lucy.
Where does Rowan fall asleep?
On the couch next to the lazy... If there is a couch,
yeah,
I imagine.
Yeah, there is a couch, yeah.
Yeah, I will fall asleep on the couch next to Amish, who tells me stories that I really oddly enjoy.
That's so cute, though.
Yeah, so anyways, I was traveling along this beach during the war, right? I can't remember which war. There's been a couple. So I'm on this beach.
And so, while she's sleeping there, I'll wake her up.
Ah! Yes?
I'm glad you're enjoying yourself.
Oh.
And, yeah. Amish over here is quite the character.
Oh, you can see he's sleeping, but as you say his name, he's like, oh, radical.
He is. I like him.
Yeah. You mind stepping outside for a little bit?
Oh, sure. Yes. Let's go.
And then, still kind of confused, we'll step outside.
What's up?
Who sent you?
What do you mean?
You said you're looking for someone, right?
I do, but I don't know who exactly.
And what are you supposed to do to this person?
I hope I'll know when I find them.
Can I do an inside check on that?
Sure.
Thirteen.
Rowan, what do you? What would you? Actually, I'll do this because this is writing a line. You're not sure whether she's telling the truth or not. She seems pretty straightforward.
She hasn't lied to you yet.
That I know of.
Yeah, there's like she's given no reason for you so far to like mistrust what she's saying. She seems genuinely confused.
Well, Rowan, let me just tell you something. If someone were to come into your life, telling you that they needed to find someone, and apparently they don't remember a thing, would you trust them?
Oh, I'm that person? Oh, okay. If they're nice? I'm sorry. Probably not.
So, can you kind of see what I'm getting to?
Should I get out of here?
No. What I'm saying is, how can we trust you?
You don't have to. Because honestly, I don't really know what I'm supposed to do myself. So I think we should continue this conversation once I know what I am and how I got here.
I would say Lucy thinks for a second, and part of hearing that she doesn't really know who she is or what she's doing kind of resonates with him a little bit. And he looks at his metal arms. And I think he'll say, you know what, I'm sorry. And he'll hold up his metal arms.
Mm-hmm.
As you can see, sacrificed a lot, and I don't want anything to happen to my friends here.
I understand that. I give you my word, whatever happens, I do not want any harm to come to your friends or you. I cannot imagine that I would want to harm anybody.
See, I will think about that. What do you reckon about me? Asking him, like, what do you think about him?
Well, at first I thought I would have to leave you in the cell because you were a criminal and I didn't want to break the law even more, but I think you're a very caring person. I think you do what you think is right. And I can't imagine I think you would do anything to protect your friends. And right now I do not. I'm not part of that group.
And Lucy holds out his right hand in the form of a handshake and says, "Well, hopefully someday you will be."
I start smiling and shake his hand as well. Relieved, very relieved. This felt like a test. Oh, thank God. Okay.
And then he drives a dagger through. I'm joking.
Honestly, she wouldn't even be mad. She would be like, yeah, that's fair.
Sorry. The two of you go back inside. Lucy, do you do anything else? Or are you going to bed?
No, I will leave it at that.
All right. You all head to bed. Dante, you don't sleep, of course.
Yep.
But you're just
sitting around.
You're just sitting around reading your book. The rest of you all head to bed. Oh, Matif, you don't sleep either. You just go into your trance. Your hashtag elf trance. Emmeth and Lucy, you find some sleep. Rowan.
Mm-hmm.
As you fade into unconsciousness and you go to sleep, you begin to get flashes of memory. Sudden visions that don't seem to make sense and seem to be disconnected. You see a grey pebble beach with a grey overcast sky. A woman who you don't recognize in clothes you've never seen before. And the color red stained into your mind, your vision. And that's all. So.
My god.
I think that is where we'll end tonight's episode. I think that's a good place to.
Oh no!
Oh wow!
Leave it on a bit of a cliffhanger.
That's so. Oh no!
But thank you for the game, everybody. Got a jailbreak in there.
That was badass, I'll just say.
Thank you for the game. It was such a joy to play with you all.
Likewise.
It was a joy to have you here.
Yeah, it was nice.
So, let's prep those emotes. Wendy's going to beat us all, probably.
I can't be bothered trying.
Let's hashtag butter ourselves.
I'm gonna take my time, boys.
Let's go. Hashtag plug ourselves. Let's start with the fastest boy himself, Wyndham Vossler.
It's me, Wyndham Vossler.
Wow.
I'm a variety streamer, detective, VTuber, and part-time cat boy. I, of course, play Dante, who is somehow more socially inept than myself. But yeah, I stream a whole bunch of stuff and at a whole bunch of times. I hope to see you guys soon on my channel.
Radical. Let's jump to Arcana the Astrid.
Hey, I'm Astrid Arcana. And I had a lot of fun today. I stream on my channel whenever I get the chance because I'm working quite a lot at the moment. So I will try to stream whenever I can. I do a bunch of art at Astrid Arcana over on Twitter and, well, mainly Twitter at the moment, but I also have an Instagram, and, I also play games. Unofficial Bethesda streamer. And, yeah, that's me.
Cool. Mr. Usabeni Yume.
Hello, everyone. You already know my name, and you can find my YouTube channel under the same name. And also on Twitter and Patreon. Sorry, but not really sorry for intimidating you, Riza. Lucy does it to everyone, don't worry.
Lucy really says square up, bro.
But yeah, today's game was really wonderful. I'm glad to get back into it. I'm very excited to see the second generation as well.
Yes. Snake Sama.
Yeah, I am Pestel the Snake on Twitch and Twitter. I do puzzles, horror, gaming stuff. We're gonna do model building on Monday, pending computer issues. Probably not, but hey, we're trying. Yeah. Oh, and I wanted to plug our YouTube.
Yes.
If you wanted to catch up with us, here's the link.
Yes, if you want to catch our VODs and catch up on the story so far, please do head to our YouTube channel. I try to get the videos out as quickly as I can, but they're all there. Definitely catch the Mind Flayer episode where Lucy dies. It's such a great episode. It's my magnum opus. It's my magnum opus.
Oh my god.
And finally, Yuriza.
Yeah, I also stream on here. I draw and I play games. And this was super exciting. I've been looking forward to this so much, and you guys are so fun to play with. Oh my god. Thank you very much for letting me be part of this today.
You are very welcome. And finally, I am your humble dungeon wizard, Merlin the Magister. I stream on my channel sometimes. A bit of variety. Been doing some chess recently, and keep an eye out for those Apex streams. Extremely mediocre gameplay incoming. keep an eye on that, it's gonna be exciting. I'm very, very keen to show off my decent Valkyrie plays. So, yeah, other than that, we have Guardians episode 1 tomorrow night for you Americans and Europeans. Monday morning for Australians and people in the Asia Pacific region. And keep an eye out on that. It's gonna be very fun. And I
join our Discord as well.
Yes, please join our Discord for all updates for both these streams and for the rest of our cast. We have links to everybody else's Discords and updates. It's very poggers. Yeah, and I think that's us for the evening. So thank you, everybody. We've been VTuber Tabletop, and we'll see you on the other side. Goodbye.
Thanks, everyone. Bye-bye.
Bye, everyone.